What if I told you the X-15, the iconic rocket plane that shattered speed records in the 1960s, was also involved in secret missions we've never heard about? Buckle up, because today we're peeling back the layers of declassified history to reveal the untold story of the X-15, the fastest, highest-flying crewed aircraft of its time. You've heard about its record-setting flights, but what you haven't heard is how this seemingly experimental aircraft quietly contributed to espionage, satellite surveillance, and even the early blueprints for space shuttles. Welcome to the shadowy side of the X-15, a tale of innovation, secrets, and the fearless pilots who danced on the edge of space. The X-15 wasn't just born from the fire of competition. It was forged in the white-hot crucible of the Cold War. In the late 1950s, as the United States and the Soviet Union entered the space race, American aerospace leaders realized that if they were going to beat the Soviets to space, they'd need to radically rethink the way aircraft flew. This meant going faster, higher, and farther than ever before, and doing it with precision. Enter the X-15, developed through a collaboration between NASA's predecessor NACA, the US Air Force, and the US Navy. The X-15 was designed not as a traditional aircraft, but as a rocket plane, a hybrid capable of flying like a plane, but with the raw thrust of a missile. Built by North American Aviation, the X-15 boasted a titanium and Inconel X-frame designed to withstand the extreme temperatures of hypersonic flight. Its rocket engine, the reaction motor's XLR-99, delivered a staggering 57,000 pounds of thrust. The early X-15 flights were all about data, learning how aircraft behaved when pushed past Mach 5, 6, and even Mach 6.7. It soared above 50 miles in altitude, breaching the edge of space and testing how pilots could maneuver in near weightlessness. These missions tested flight control systems, heat resistance, aerodynamic behavior, and pilot physiology under immense stress. But this was just the beginning. While the world applauded the X-15 for its technological brilliance, another story was quietly unfolding, one that wouldn't be told for decades. On the surface, the X-15 was a research craft, but in the shadows, it was something more. A testbed for covert reconnaissance technologies and classified aerospace experiments. With the Cold War heating up and fears of Soviet missile superiority growing, the US intelligence community saw the X-15 as a unique platform to collect high-altitude data, test surveillance systems, and study the upper atmosphere in ways that satellites couldn't yet achieve. Documents declassified in recent decades reveal that several X-15 flights carried experimental payloads for the Department of Defense. These included prototype sensors for satellite tracking, infrared surveillance, and even early laser targeting systems. Because the X-15 could reach altitudes above 300,000 feet, far higher than conventional aircraft, it served as the perfect platform to simulate space-based operations. Long before America had a robust fleet of reconnaissance satellites in orbit, in one particularly secretive mission, an X-15 flight reportedly tested optics intended for future spy satellites. These missions were conducted with minimal public attention and sometimes under the guise of routine research flights. Even the pilots often didn't know the full purpose of the experiments they were conducting. One pilot later remarked that we were flying science missions, but some of those science experiments had strategic importance we only realized years later. It's now understood that the X-15 played a quiet but critical role in shaping US intelligence gathering capabilities during one of the tensest periods of the 20th century. Of course, not everything about the X-15 was covert. Its public achievements were just as astonishing, and arguably, just as important. The X-15 broke barriers that had once been thought impassable. It became the first crewed aircraft to fly at speeds greater than Mach 6.7 over 4,500 miles per hour, and altitudes above 354,000 feet. Eight pilots earned astronaut wings for crossing the Kármán line, the internationally recognized boundary of space. The pilots were among the bravest and most skilled in aviation history. Neil Armstrong, before becoming the first man on the moon, cut his teeth in the X-15 program. Other legends like Joe Walker, Robert White, and William Pete Knight routinely risked their lives pushing this rocket-powered beast to its limits. Inside the cramped, pressure-sealed cockpit, pilots endured intense G-forces on ascent and descent, blistering cabin temperatures, and the very real possibility of total system failure. One pilot described it as strapping yourself to a bomb and lighting the fuse, but the rewards were enormous. Every flight brought back crucial data: how materials behaved at extreme speeds, how to control re-entry trajectories, and how human bodies coped with near-space conditions. This information was vital, not only for future aircraft, but for spacecraft as well. In fact, the X-15's adjustable control surfaces, energy management techniques, and reaction control systems became direct predecessors of systems used on Mercury, Gemini, Apollo, and later, the Space Shuttle. By the time the X-15 program ended in 1968, it had completed 199 flights and amassed a legacy that went far beyond the headlines of the day. Much of what we now take for granted in modern spaceflight was pioneered by the X-15. Its research into heat shielding, supersonic control surfaces, and pilot health monitoring laid the groundwork for the design of reusable spacecraft. The idea of bringing a winged vehicle back from space and landing it like a plane? That's the X-15's legacy. The program directly influenced NASA's space shuttle design. Engineers borrowed thermal protection systems and flight control models refined during X-15 tests. Even the X-37B, a secretive military space plane currently operated by the U.S. Space Force, can trace its heritage back to the X-15's daring test flights. And the cultural legacy? It's just as powerful. The X-15 proved that a bold vision, supported by cutting-edge science and fearless pilots, could make the impossible real. It inspired a generation of aerospace engineers, astronauts, and dreamers who saw in it the ultimate fusion of man and machine. But perhaps its most important lesson lies in its hidden chapters, the missions that remained classified, the technologies that were tested in secret, and the quiet heroism of those who flew, knowing that the full story of their contributions might never be told. The X-15 was more than a research aircraft. It was a proving ground for everything the future of aerospace could become. At a time when the world was focused on the moon, the X-15 was already testing what it meant to fly at the edge of space, to control a vehicle re-entering Earth's atmosphere at Mach speeds, and to gather data that satellites hadn't even been invented to collect. It did this in the daylight and in the shadows. And today, as we move into a new space age of private spaceflight, hypersonic vehicles, and next-generation spaceplanes, the lessons of the X-15 remain profoundly relevant. Its test flights weren't just fast or high, they were foundational. A silent bridge between the dawn of the jet age and the age of human spaceflight. So the next time you see a rocket roar skyward, or hear about a classified spacecraft re-entering Earth's atmosphere, remember, the X-15 was there first. The world watched it break records, but history will remember it for breaking boundaries. Thanks for joining us on this high-speed dive into the classified history of the X-15. If you enjoyed uncovering the secrets behind one of the most legendary aircraft ever built, you won't want to miss what's coming next. Subscribe to @BeyondEarth Buckle Up for more untold stories from the frontiers of space and aviation, where history meets mystery, and the truth is often stranger than fiction.